إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. Inshallah, in this segment, we're going to be talking about the i'tikaf since we are approaching the last 10 days of Ramadan. And we're going to define i'tikaf linguistically and after this religiously. Al-i'tikaf, lughatan, luzum al-shay' wa habsun nafs alay. To stick to something or to lock yourself up for a something. This called i'tikaf. As for the Sharia explanation or definition of the word i'tikaf, المقام في المسجد من شخص مخصوص على صفة مخصوصة. A person to stay in the mosque in a special way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had legislated the i'tikaf and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had recommended and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make i'tikaf towards the end of Ramadan until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused him to die. So it is something which is in the Sharia and being practiced by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعتكف في كل رمضان عشرة أيام فلما كان العام الذي قبض فيه اعتكف 20 يوما. The collection of Imam al-Bukhari رحمة الله عليه that Abu Huraira reported that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make اعتكاف 10 days of every Ramadan every year with exception of the last year when he passed away. This year he had made i'tikaf for 20 days. Sheikh al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi say that al-i'tikaf sunnah fi Ramadan wa ghayrihi min ayyam al-sana. It is recommended act in all the year at any time during the year as well as in Ramadan. And the originality or legislation of this, the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 187, وَلَا تُبَاشِرُهُنَّ وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. And do not have a relationship with your wives while you are in seclusion, while you are in a state of i'tikaf. The ruling of it, الاعتكاف سنة. اعتكاف is optional unless a person make it upon himself. As example, a person will make a vow, nadhr. As example, somebody said, if I pass this exam, I'm going to make i'tikaf for 5 days. And it happened to pass the exam. So now he had made this obligation upon himself. He have to fulfill it. He have to make i'tikaf for 5 days. So the originality of the i'tikaf, it is sunnah, is recommended unless a person will make it incumbent upon himself by making another, so he have to fulfill this. Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, reported that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, "Man nazara an yuti' Allah falyuti', wa man nazara an ya'siyahu fala ya'si." The collection of Imam al-Bukhari, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, is saying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, "Whosoever take a oath or make a vow that he will obey Allah or do act of obedience, let him fulfill it. And whosoever made a vow to disobey Allah, let him not to do so." Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu said, "O Prophet of Allah, I had made nazr during the time of Jahiliyyah, the days of Jahiliyyah, before Islam. And his nazr, his vow, while he was in the Jahiliyyah, to make i'tikaf one night in the mosque of Mecca, Masjid al-Haram. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, 'Awfi binazrika,' fulfill your obligation. Keep this promise that you made it to Allah." What's the purpose behind i'tikaf? Maqsud al-i'tikaf. Imam ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullah alayhi in his book Zad al-Ma'ad said, لما كان صلاح القلب واستقامته على طريقة سيره إلى الله تبارك وتعالى متوقفا على جمعيته على الله ولم شعثه بإقباله بالكلية على الله تعالى فإن شعث القلب لا يلمه إلا الإقبال على الله وكان فضول الطعام والشراب وفضول مخالطة الأنام وفضول الكلام وفضول المنام مما يزيده شعثا ويشتته في كل وادي ويقطعه عن سيره إلى الله تعالى أو يضعفه أو يعوقه ويوقفه اقتضت رحمة العزيز الرحيم بعباده أن شرع له من الصوم ما يذهب فضول الطعام والشراب ويستفرغ من القلب أخلاط الشهوات المعوقة له في سيره إلى الله تعالى وشرعه بقدر المصلحة بحيث ينتفع به العبد في دنياه وآخره وأخرى ولا يضره ولا يقطعه عن مصالح العاجلة والآجلة وشرع لهم الاعتكاف الذي مقصوده وروحه عكوف القلب على الله تعالى وجمعيته عليه والخلو به والانقطاع عن الاشتغال بالخلق والاشتغال به وحده سبحانه وتعالى بحيث يصير ذكره وحبه والإقبال عليه في محل هموم القلب وخطراته فاستولى عليه بدلا ويصير الهم كله به والخطرات كلها بذكره والتفكر في تحصيل مراديه وما يقرب منه فيصير أنسه بالله بدل من أنسه بالخلق فيعيد بذلك لأنسه به يوم الوحشة في القبور حين لا أنيس له ولا ما يفرح به سواه فهذا مقصود الاعتكاف الأعظم. Imam ibn al-Qayyim رحمة الله عليه explaining the purpose behind i'tikaf and he said the way to fix your heart and to keep your heart in his journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala required that you keep your heart focusing on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the heart, it gets busy with many things in this dunya. And one of the things that distracting the heart from focusing on Allah or became an obstacle in the way to Allah, extra food, extra drink, and extra mixing with the people and socialization, and extra talk, unnecessary talk, and also sleep. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the fasting to be a means and ways that it can sift the person from all these things that occupy him in this life, extra sleep, extra talk, extra all these things, and this through the siyam and the fasting. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
made the fasting to be during the day. So it can remove this extra things that you don't need, which became an obstacle for you to reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From all these desires, from foods and sex and other things, and socialization with the people. And Allah had legislated the fasting in a certain time with amount which can be beneficial for you to your journey to Allah without also hurting you about what you try to achieve in this life. So also in addition to this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislate al-i'tikaf, which is the main purpose of it, that the heart will be focusing in Allah and have privacy with Allah, and to stay away from unnecessary talk and socialization with the people. So became the main love is Allah, and that your main concern is get closer to Allah. So this became your main worry and became your main thoughts. So this will make you try to please Allah more and get closer to Him. So if you did so in the i'tikaf as well as the fasting, so now you will be delighted in the company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than you be happy when you socialize with the people. And this will prepare you so you can have a way that can help you when you became lonely in the grave, which no one will accompany you or no one will socialize with you. So there will be nothing there in your grave which make you happy or make you content other than the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the purpose behind the i'tikaf, is to try to bring your heart in a focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What time we can make i'tikaf? I'tikaf, which is recommended, it can be in any day during the year. It has been confirmed and affirmed that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made i'tikaf in the last 10 days from Shawwal, or the first 10 days from Shawwal. Then he left this and shift his i'tikaf to Shahr Ramadan. The most recommended days is i'tikaf during Ramadan, as been reported by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make i'tikaf in all Ramadan, 10 days from each month, each year. In the year that he passed away, he made i'tikaf for 20 days. The most recommended days in Ramadan is the latter part. As been reported, the Prophet ﷺ used to make i'tikaf in the latter days from Ramadan until Allah call him to him. What is the condition of i'tikaf? Number one, yet you have to be a Muslim. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُ. If somebody commit a shirk, all his deed will be vanished or be spoiled. So it has to be the person to be Muslim for i'tikaf to be acceptable. Number two, that you have to be in a state of mind, in not to be a crazy, not to be, you don't know what you're doing. Aisha reported the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, رُفِعَ الْقَلِمُ عَنْ ثَلَاثِ. The pen been lifted from three persons, and na'im hatta yastaqidh, wal majnun hatta ya'qil aw yafiq, wa 'an as-sabiy hatta yahtalim. Three people are exempt, or the pen been lifted from three people: a child until it reaches the age of puberty, a person who insanity that until he get to his senses, and a person who overslept until he wake up. I'tikaf have to be done in a mosque, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلَا تُبَشِرُهُنَّ وَأَنْتُفْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. I'tikaf have to be in one of the mosques, which is the people make the five-time prayers and make the Jum'ah. So i'tikaf is not to be done in the house or to be any place other than the mosque. A person who are in a state of i'tikaf, he doesn't supposed to leave his mu'takaf, the place of i'tikaf, unless there is a necessity. Like as example, he have to use the bathroom or to make a new wudu. He doesn't go for visiting a sick, he doesn't go for anything outside unless it's something have to. It is also recommended a person who are in a state of i'tikaf to be fasting. حديث عائشة may Allah be pleased with her والسنة في من اعتكف أن يصوم. It is the sunnah that a person who want to be in اعتكاف to be fasting. إمام ابن القيم رحمة الله عليه in his book زاد المعاد he said لم ينقل عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه اعتكف مفطرا قط. Never been recorded the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made اعتكاف while he's breaking his fast. And Aisha said, لا اعتكاف إلا بصوم. No اعتكاف without fasting. Nobody mentions that اعتكاف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم unless that he was fasting. Never the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made اعتكاف without being fasting. The most authentic that a person and the jumhur of the Salaf that fasting is a condition with the i'tikaf. And this is what Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah also supported. When a person will start his i'tikaf, Aisha reported, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أراد أن يعتكف صلى الفجر ثم دخل معتكفه. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم want to make i'tikaf, he will pray Fajr, and after this he will enter his معتكف. The place he make i'tikaf in it. Sheikh al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi bin question concerning a person or the statement of some of the scholars when he want to make i'tikaf he will enter before sunset from that day. He says this also is more is permissible. The main thing that the person will enter while he are in a state of fasting. So if a person enter before sunset while he's still fasting, this will be also count. Or otherwise he will make his suhoor fajr and after this he will make start his i'tikaf. What is recommended for a person who is making i'tikaf? That the person to occupy himself with the salah, recitation of the Quran, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all the kind of obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To avoid what is not his concern from action or saying. Not to be talking a lot, because with talking a lot, it causes a person to fall into a sin and mistakes. Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعني. One of the main characteristics of the Muslim is leaving alone what doesn't concern him. It is better for a person, and this is the opinion of Imam Ahmad, rahmatullah alayh, that the person not to occupy himself of teaching Quran or knowledge or dialoguing or sitting with the people or kitabat al-hadith or anything which is beneficial for others. that this is not recommended for him to focus in his own self and his own ibadah. Imam ibn Qudamah rahmatullah alayhi said, وَلَيْسَ فِي شَرِيعَةِ الْإِسْلَامِ الصَّمْتِ عَنِ الْكَلَامِ وَظَاهِرِ الْأَخْبَارِ تَحْرِيمُهُ is not part of i'tikaf, neither it is part of the sharia of al-Islam that the person totally to be quiet. Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, enter on a woman from Ahmas, her name is Zainab, Faraha, and he saw her, she doesn't talk. He said, what's wrong with her, why she's not talking? He said, Hajjat Musmata, she performed Hajj without talking to anybody. He said to her that she have to talk because this is not permissible, and this from the act of the Jahiliyyah pre-Islam. وعن علي رضي الله عنه قال I had memorized from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم no one to remain quiet for a whole day or up to the night. If a person made a vow that in his i'tikaf not to talk, he's not supposed to fulfill this kind of condition. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in hadith which is reported by Ibn Abbas said, while the Prophet was given khutbah, a man was standing, he asked about him, he said, this is Abu Israel. He made a vow to be standing, not to sit, and not to be under the shade, and not talk, and to be fasting. The Prophet ﷺ said, مره فليتكلم وليستظل وليقعد وليتم صوم. Order him to talk, and to be under a shade, and let him sit down, and let him continue his fasting. What is permissible for a person who is in i'tikaf? To step outside of the mosque for a necessity, or he stick his head out of the mosque for his head to be washed or to be combed. And not to try to exceed necessity of going out of the i'tikaf. It is permissible for the person who make an i'tikaf to have a small tent in the end of the mosque to be inside it. And this had been done for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, it is permissible for the wife to go to visit her husband during i'tikaf. As Safiya, may Allah be pleased with her, she went to visit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was in the i'tikaf. Basically, inshallah, this general talk about i'tikaf, since we are approaching the last 10 days, and the last 10 days, as we understand, it contain on Laylatul Qadr. And if a person try to catch Laylatul Qadr, he doesn't have to be in i'tikaf, but will give him a better opportunity to catch with the night of Laylatul Qadr, inshallah. Any comments, any concern, any question, please feel free to do so.
Yeah, sure.
Yes.
You said that itikaf meant to take an oath. Is this the same thing like It's pre-Islamic when Abu Talib, I think it was, made up.
No, there is two different words. One i'tikaf and one nadr. Nadr is a vow.
Okay.
But the i'tikaf is to stick in one place. Okay? So i'tikaf is a seclusion, to stay in the mosque. Okay. One is nadr, that you promise Allah, if He fulfills such and such to you, you will do this. This is called nadr. Yeah. I'tikaf is to stay a period of time, a day, 10 days, a week, inside the mosque.
Okay. What's the minimum? Is it one day, 24 hours minimum?
Yes, you can, minimum you make one day at i'tikaf.
In the daytime and nighttime, or just daytime?
You enter, okay, while you are in a state of fasting, so it have to be sometime between Fajr and before sunset.
And after sunset, you can go back home.
No, you enter the i'tikaf, okay, before sunset, and you stay overnight, okay? So you make like 24 hours. Question, comments, concern? All right. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Inshallah, we'd like to spend about 15 minutes.